Welcome back into the Tell Me Moment here. Earlier today, I was preaching in Pakistan by way of Zoom and also by way of WhatsApp. And I deal with different groups in the country of Pakistan, which is the second largest Muslim country in the world. And in that group and in that setting, there are many, many Christians there. And I want you to understand something, because today was a very unique situation in one of the groups that I was dealing with. And they asked me to commission and help them to commission two couples to go into the mission field, into the other areas of the country, to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. And they asked me to read the Great Commission, of course, in Matthew chapter 28. And look at this, what he says in verse 19 and 20, Matthew chapter 28. He says, and he says, go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I command you. And lo, I am with you, he says, always, even to the end of the age. And as we finished our prayer time and we were talking about being sent forth, and they were going. They had the equivalent, a total of $100 on their purse. And I asked them, I says, you're still going? They said, yes. The Bible in Matthew chapter 28, these are the believers in Pakistan telling me. The Bible says, go. It says, go therefore make disciples of all the nations. It is. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We can't wait to raise the money. We can't wait to raise the funds. We've been called to go. It's on the road to go. The churches, the house churches gathered and said, we will make provision for them as they go. But they're going to go at a great risk to their own lives. It's a completely different mindset when you think about it. You know, Pakistan has a population of 221 million people. 95 to 98% of them are Muslims, okay? They're Sunni Muslims. That's the majority of them there. Okay? And so I asked them, and I said, well, do you fear for the coronavirus? And they said, no. You know, in a country of 221 million people plus, okay, the country of Pakistan is officially has registered 292,000 plus infections. However, what you don't know is that 275,000 out of the 292,000 have recovered. In other words, 94% of people have recovered from coronavirus. There's only 10,000 plus active cases in the country of Pakistan. Now, they've lost 6,235 people to the coronavirus. And I asked them, I says, and you're still going to go? And they said, yes. We would rather die in the service for Christ, in fulfilling the Great Commission, than to live at home, locked up in the four walls, in a state of fear. The church must rise to the occasion. And this I know from many, many years working in that country of Pakistan. Right? And I asked them, I says, are you afraid of dying? They said, no. In fact, they told me 18,000, listen to this carefully, 18,364 Christians, 18,364 Christians have been killed in Pakistan for their faith. Compare that to 6,235 people who have died from coronavirus. Which of the two are you more likely to die from if you're a believer? Think about that. They're not waiting to raise the money. They're not waiting because whenever the coronavirus is going to be over with. No. They're going to go. When will the church around the world rise to the occasion and fulfill the Great Commission? We Christians are people of the book, and we believe in eternal life. What are we holding on to in this world?